At a time when data is showing worryingly that malnutrition is growing across India, the Prime Minister's Poshan Yojana has been announced, reinventing the midday meal scheme. Uma Sudhir investigates exactly what new it brings to the plate.
After 17 months of lockdown during the COVID pandemic, this Anganwadi has opened in Telangana. Attendance is good not just for the play and learning, but also because a midday meal is once again being served here.
Since 2015, at Anganwadis or Balvatikas like this one, children have been getting a midday meal, which means cooked rice as well as sambar that will have dal and some vegetable component. Every day they get one egg and on Wednesdays they get two eggs. Pregnant and lactating women can come and have their lunch here too.
The newly announced Pradhan Mantri Poshan Yojana will entitle 24 lakh pre-primary children in Balvatikas that are attached to schools to also get a midday meal. So far, it was only 11.8 crore children in class 1 to 8 in 11.2 lakh schools who benefited. The National Education Policy 2020 had in fact recommended that pre-primary children should be included in the midday meal scheme and also that breakfast should be offered to all the students. Providing breakfast would have cost an additional 4,000 crore rupees and has not been included. Additional components of PM Poshan include monitoring holistic nutrition status, providing additional nutrition where required like in anemic children, traditional foods, local cuisine to be included, nutrition gardens to be encouraged in schools, social audit to ensure quality food delivery.
Desh ke crorodon nirdhan parivaron se aane wale bachchon ko जो सरकारी स्कूलों में जाते हैं उनके लिए पीएम पोषण और इस योजना के माध्यम से सरकारी स्कूलों में जाने वाले विद्यार्थियों को या गवर्नमेंट एडेड स्कूल हो उसके विद्यार्थियों को भी ऐसे 11 लाख 20 हजार से ज़्यादा स्कूलों के करोड़ों विद्यार्थियों को दोपहर का भोजन भी मिलेगा और 5 वर्ष तक चलने वाली पीएम पोषण में 1,31,000 crore rupees ka vyay hoga.
Data from the latest round of National Family Health Survey collected before the COVID pandemic had said in most states malnutrition and the percentage of children with stunted growth had gone up in the last 5 years. This includes major states like Gujarat, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Bihar, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Kerala and Himachal Pradesh. In Telangana, every third child is malnourished. In Kerala, that leads in human development indices like literacy and sex ratio. Every fifth child has stunted growth and over 15% are underweight. The big worry is that the pandemic period would have made matters worse for India's poorest children.
అవును చాలా పిల్లలు చాలా వీక్ అయిపోయారు. అంతకుముందు మా దగ్గర చెగ్గ తిన్న పిల్లలు బాగుండే. తర్వాత అంతా ఇంట్లో ఉండే వరకు వాళ్ళ ఫాదర్ ఏం పెట్టారో పెట్టలేదో తెలియదు. లాస్ అయ్యారు మేడం చాలా పిల్లలు.
Gayatri studies at a social welfare hostel. Her father died 2 years ago and her mother works as a domestic help. She says for the last 18 months, no school has meant no nutritious meals.
In our home, there is no rice and no eggs, curd. In hostel, there are so many items to eat, but in our home, very tight, ma'am. That's why we are not taking nutrition food, ma'am. There is not there healthy food, ma'am, in our home. That's why I get health problem.
India has the highest percentage of underweight children in South Asia. It would take more than a cosmetic rebranding of the 26-year-old National Midday Meal Scheme to secure India's future. In Hyderabad, with camera person Nagraju, Uma Sudhir, NDTV.